Welcome to the Overflow Worship Podcast, where we serve and support leaders so you can serve and support your local church.
Well, hey, everybody. Welcome to the Overflow Worship Podcast. It's me, your host, Andrea Olson. Guys, I am just coming off of an incredibly busy season. For those of you who have been a part of the Overflow Worship family for a long time, you know that the second weekend in October every year we have a conference. We have the Overflow Worship Conference. And so, you know, it was a beautiful weekend. We had such an amazing time and it was really special. But it does take me a little bit of time to recover and put things back in order in my house and kind of all the things that get neglected or just kind of pushed off to the side for those final busy weeks as we push to the conference. And so I finally feel like I've got out of the fog and got my feet back under me a little bit. And so we took a break from the podcast for that weekend because of everything that we had going on. But I just wanted to come back with a shorter episode today because there's something on my heart that I want to share with you. And I think it's something that we really purposed to focus on at the conference. But for those of you who weren't there, I just really want to give you a little bit of encouragement and a little bit of a push to fight for this. And the words that are on my heart have to do with the theme of the conference, which our theme was pause. And it was all about breathe. Our theme was breathe and pause. And so before every session, before every main session, and at the open of the weekend and the close of the weekend, we took a breath. And we just took a deep breath and let God's peace wash over us because this season has been crazy. It has been maybe filled with anxiety or fear or worry. And so we wanted to provide a place for worship leaders and their teams to just breathe. And so along with that, I want to share with you today that I really believe that the Lord wants us to be still and rest in Him. And if you've been with me for a while, you know that this has been a theme of my heart for the last couple of years even. But I really believe that as we launch into this next season, we're coming into fall and Thanksgiving and Christmas and on all of these different worship leader groups that I'm a part of, everybody's talking about Christmas songs and what are we going to, you know, what songs are you guys doing for Christmas and all of that. So it's coming quick. But here's the thing. I believe that God wants us to posture our hearts in such a way where we walk into that season from a place of rest and stillness. And, you know, in Psalm 46, it says it so well towards the end. I'm reading from the Passion Translation, but it says in chapter 46, verse 10 and 11, surrender your anxiety, be still and realize that I am God. I am God above all the nations, and I am exalted throughout the whole earth. And actually, I'm going to stop there. That's just verse 10 for now. And I believe that that's the posture God wants us to live in. So I encourage you today to ask yourself, where am I at with this? Am I living in anxiety or busyness, or am I able to be still? Am I able to rest? And rest doesn't necessarily mean sleep. It maybe does, but living from a place of rest where you actually take the time to be in the presence of the Lord for no other reason than to just be there and be with Him. You know, I was having a conversation with somebody and they said to me, you know, if I'm not doing all the things on Sunday morning that need to be done on stage. So for example, maybe you're running tracks and you're leading the band and you're playing lead guitar and you're leading worship. Because that's a reality for a lot of us, most of us in the local church, where there's just a lot of hats that you have to wear. And he was saying, and you know what? I want to delegate those things. I want to raise people up. I want to let other people do it. But I'm afraid that if I do, then what will I do from stage? Like, I don't know if I know how to quiet myself enough or posture myself where I am only leading worship. Like, what is that like mentally to let those other things go and just be present in worship? And my response was, you know, maybe it's because your life is so busy and your life is so hectic that you don't actually have the space in your life and you're not taking the time to be still before the Lord in those hidden places. And so I just said, I challenge you to find the space, make the space. You're probably not going to find it, actually. You're going to have to make it to be still before the Lord and to spend time in His presence in your own hidden places. No one else is around. No one's telling you to. No one's making you, but you're doing it, making it a priority because it is so important. Because what happens is we lead from those hidden places. It's the overflow of those hidden places that we step into on stage and lead from on stage. And so I encouraged him to do that. And then you may find that even if all the busyness goes away and all the things that you used to do are now filled by amazing team members, those that someone's triggering the track, someone else is playing lead guitar, maybe you're only singing and leading, but you're not scared of that because you're leading from the overflow and your heart and your mind are just ready. And so I just encourage you with that today to find time, make time to be still and rest in the Lord so that as you walk into this next season, you are walking into it from a place of rest. And so as you do that, I challenge you to read through scripture. You know, maybe it's the Psalms. Maybe it is Psalm 46. We actually journeyed through three different Psalms at the conference, and it was a beautiful thing. Psalm 23, Psalm 42, and Psalm 46. And it was such a beautiful thing for all of us to journey through that together. So maybe you start with the Psalms, but I challenge you to dig into scripture and declare the truth of scripture over your life. And then as it says in Psalm 46, in the Passion Translation, at the end of each section, it says, pause in His presence. When was the last time you paused in His presence or took time for a Selah? I believe that's what God wants for you. He wants you to make time for that, to pause in His presence, to declare scripture over your life, declare the truth over your life, and then pause in His presence and just listen, just be there. Sometimes for me, I think I got to go to the Lord with a purpose. I need to have a specific, you know, this is why I'm here. I'm praying for this person, or I'm praying for that person, or I'm asking about this, or I'm thanking Him for that. And sometimes I think it's just, He just wants to be with us and He just wants us to be there in His presence. And so not only am I challenging you, but I'm also challenging myself because in the busyness of this last season, I have not taken the time like I know that I want to and need to just sit and not have an agenda in His presence. So friends, surrender your anxiety, be still and realize that He is God. He is God above all the nations and He is exalted throughout the whole earth. I pray for you that you can walk into this season of holidays and whatever that looks like for you. I pray that you can walk into it from a place of rest and a place of stillness because you have purposed to take the time to rest and be still in His presence. And hey, you know what? Bring your journal with you because the Lord is going to reveal things to you in those moments and times where you're in His presence. So I challenge you to just listen and write down what He's saying to you because I guarantee you that those revelations will be powerful and transformational for you, whether right now or in the future. And that journal is like a monument, right? You can look back on it and see the things that He said, see His faithfulness throughout all the days of your life. So let's live our lives, not only now in this season, but moving forward and throughout our lives from a place of stillness and a place of rest. So speaking of Christmas, I also wanted to share with you something super exciting. I'm releasing a Christmas song for the first time in many years. I used to do Christmas albums years and years ago, and I did them for a specific purpose. I actually wrote and arranged songs specifically for businesses that wanted to give Christmas gifts to their clients. And so I created this unique Christmas album that then they would brand for their company and send out as a Christmas gift. So that was, you know, 10 years ago, maybe even more. And it was a sweet part of my story, but I am releasing a Christmas song that I'm really excited about because it's for the church. It's for you guys. And I've heard from a lot of people that, you know, when is new music coming for the church to sing? And specifically, you know, that's accessible. It's accessible for volunteer players to play, but it also is rooted in scripture and easy to sing. And so I got together with Paul Balash and Meredith Andrews and rewrote this song. And guys, I'm so excited to share it with you. And it's coming on November 19th. But here's the thing, okay? We have some really exciting things happening with just all the resources for the song, and I want to make them available to you very soon. So within the next week, what we are going to do is we are going to be sharing the resources early for anybody who subscribes to overflowresource.com. And overflowresource.com is our subscription-based site, and it is purely created for the local church. I want you to see, first of all, that you have value where you are. The ministry that you're doing is valuable where you are, and you can truly thrive with what you have wherever you are. And so this community, this subscription site, was curated specifically to help you with that. So what we do is we have training tools, we have training videos that help you with everything from, you know, establishing team foundations, establishing, you know, kind of maybe a policy or team values, to training vocalists, to training band members, to devotionals, and kind of all the full spectrum of resources, but they're topic based. They're not song based. So my goal with creating all these resources is that they're relevant for you and your context. It's not just here, learn to play this one song, but it's actually here are concepts using maybe a specific song, but they apply globally to many different songs. And we also, of course, have chord charts and that kind of thing too. So you can access those to the songs that I'm releasing. But for those of you who are subscribers, for the Overflow Resource website, you guys are going to get early access to all of the resources for the Christmas song so you can prep it and do it in church in the Christmas season. I want to give you enough time to get ready and let your teams learn it and all the things. So we've got acoustic music videos. We've got MP3s to listen to the full produced version. I've got chord charts. I've got stems. I've got discounts for you to get additional stems for multi-tracks. I've got tutorials and just really fun things, and you're going to get access to them. So all you have to do is be a subscriber. So how you do that is you go to overflowresource.com and you can pick a plan. There's a basic plan and there is a premium plan, and you can kind of see what would fit best for you and then give it a shot. And I would absolutely love to have you be a part of this community. So if you want access to the brand new song, it's called The Proof. I would love to give that to you. So join us at Overflow Resource, join the community, join the family. We would love to have you there. All right, friends, that's it for today. It's a short little episode. And after all is said and done, remember, before you go on your way, work hard to find a place, find a way to live from a place of stillness and a place of rest. And you might have to fight for it. You might have to work. That's why I said you got to work hard. Because it's not easy. Life's going to get busy. Things are going to get thrown at you. The noise is going to be great, but we can do this. So let's surrender our anxiety, be still, and realize that He is God. He's God above all the nations and exalted throughout the whole earth.
You've been listening to the Overflow Worship Podcast. If you enjoy our podcast, please take a moment and leave us a 5-star rating and a written review, which helps us reach more people. New episodes are released every other Monday. So until next time, thank you for listening.